Okay, let's now assign some resources to actually perform those activities. Let's first define some roles, the different roles we will need to do our project. If you go to properties, resource roles, you can do add. I will need an app programmer. I will need an consultant. I will need some testers. I could use an analyst. And I could use a project manager. Okay, confirm this. Then you need to have a look into the resource chart. So you have the Gantt view here. You have also a resource view, which shows when resources are used on the timeline. But you need first to create your resources. So if you right mouse click in this empty area, you can add a resource, or you can also hit Ctrl H. So we will create Johnny Manage, who is our project manager, and his phone number, at his mail address. And give him the main role of project manager. Doesn't mean that he can't do other tasks, but his main role is the one of project manager. And then you need to fill in the daily rate your company will charge, wants to use as basis for cost calculation. This can be quite high. For example, here for a project manager, I think €700 would be a good starter. Looks high, sounds high, €700 for a project manager every day. I mean, it's not that this guy will earn that much. Maybe he will earn €3,500, €4,000 netto or so. So it's surely not 700 times the number of days. But this is still correct, because you need to pay for all the overheads in your company, like the management layers, like the nice building. Click OK. Create some other resources. We need a programmer. Mark Bit. And he's an app programmer. And we will charge him €450 a day. Add some other roles. It's also a programmer. €460. Add an analyst. Probably quite expensive. Let's take €850. Maybe a tester. 280 euros. Okay. So I have defined my resources. Now you go back to the Gantt chart and move to the lower level activities, tasks, like so those ones which are in blue. I would not assign resources to main tasks. This is often a cause for errors where double counting or so of resources happen. So it's cleaner if you only assign resources to the subtasks. Okay, I have my market survey. Double click it. You can you go to the tab resources. You do add. I will select Mieke Analyze. Now the important thing to understand is that you must very accurately reason on the amount of work Mieke will have to do. The duration of the market survey is 10 days, but this does not at all mean that it's 10 days work. Not at all. It's probably one day or so to prepare the survey and to send it out, and maybe half a day or so to process the results. So it should surely not be 100%. So it should not be 10 working days for Mieke. If Mieke will work one day in total on this activity, which has a duration of 10, you should enter 10%. It's very important to do this accurately, because the salary of Mieke is coupled to the amount of work she has to perform. So if you don't put the right percentage here, taking in account the duration of the task, your costing will be completely wrong. You can add other resources if you want to, like assume that Johnny Precise will also help a bit with the interview work for 20%. You can add him. Okay, and so the idea now is to walk every activity and assign those resources to every activity, every sub-activity. Thanks for watching.